from this position, it's pretty easy for him, especially if he has to do like a car trip. Yeah, so if he has this and he loads me on top of him this way, then it's easy for him to start going to see like X or X guard or whatever position he wants to be in this position. But if I can get to where I'm like this, and then I hide this foot here, that position, that same position doesn't work anymore. So he can't even go ahead and try to load me on top. You can get X guard again or single leg X or something. So this is why I'm stapling here. And preferably, you don't want this to be down here by his knee, or especially below his knee or anything. I want to get it as high to his hip as I can get it up here to really kind of like stretch him out from this position. This isn't the technique we've got to get him to tap in the circle from here, but you want to just be high up here on his hips to kind of really broaden his space from here. Does that make sense? Okay, so let's go over the different positions here since we're talking about the knee shield. So if I'm coming here to do like a knee cut, and he gets this reverse of the human, he has this knee shield in here, then we're going to go through one of the positions. It's going to put us in the inverted half here, so we pass from this position. So this knee shield can be super annoying to try to deal with from this position, but what's interesting kind of about the knee shield also that I have been realizing is that the more, because I'm a pressure passer, and so I'm constantly like driving in to my partner, but if he has the knee shield and I'm driving into him, I'm giving him what he wants, you know, like he can control the distance and stuff from here, because I'm driving in to his knee shield. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to kind of go around his power from his knee shield. It feels a little bit counterintuitive, but I'm going to post, I'm going to put my knee on the ground, and I'm going to push this past my hips, and as I drag my hips forward, I'm pushing this below my hips like this. Okay, so we went from being on our feet like this to being doing like a cross knee slice pass, post, knee goes on the ground, and then I'm going to lean forward, and I'm going to push his knee down, and then below my hips, just like this. Okay, so once we're in this position, then I'm going to start switching my grip. So I'm going to windshield wiper. This leg is going to come up and over his foot like this, and then I'm going to walk to this side. As soon as I hit the ground, I'm going to start shooting my hips back. This hand is either going to go underneath to get the cross space holding his shoulder, or you can go underneath under his armpit here. Does that make sense?
Well, why wouldn't you take your back at that point that you're clearing his knee?
When I was looking,
what's stopping?
So when I'm in this position like this.
Yeah.
The hand is not available from this position. So I'm here on his hip with his knee, and I have his knee.
Like, is that knee pinned to the mat or something to stop him from?
I'm either holding the material like this, putting them together, or I'm just pushing it behind me like this. But even when I get to this position and I have this hip over, there's still no back kick from here. Because even if he comes in like this, it's still I'm going to go right into the same position that I wanted to be in.
Okay. So, yeah, but it's because you pinned that hip.
Is that not true?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. So,
does anybody not know what a reverse day of the human hook is? Do you guys not know what a reverse day of the human hook is?
So, when he goes to go for his pass, watch this foot, okay? It's where I'm hooking his hip and I'm trying to get my knee shield. So, sometimes this one will go underneath, that's really popular, and just kind of close me. So, just give your partner a good look, okay?
So, once we're in this position, I'm going to post, put my knee on the ground, and I'm going to start pushing his knee behind me. And if I stay here and I'm just trying to push his knee, it can be pretty hard to just get his leg out of the way. So I'm going to move myself up and as I push his leg down. And now that it's below my butt here, then I can catch it. And then I can start coming this side. As soon as I touch, I'm blocking this leg. This can go underneath. It can go over the, this is a preferable position, but you can switch that in a minute. You'll end up landing in a position similar to this. Lock this leg and just scoot up here by his armpit. And then there's a bunch of passes that you do from here. But.